I know, it kind of feels like I already made this video a while ago, and I did, but I kind of refreshed the setup because I was a little dissatisfied with how small my desk was. The L-shaped desk I was using is still great. In fact, I'm using them in the game room now for two different setups. I have two of them kind of combined. They're reversible, which is great as well, so it'll kind of fit into any corner of any room as long as you have sufficient space on both sides. Needless to say, I wanted a lot more real estate in terms of desk space, and these birchwood tabletops definitely changed the game. Yeah, I kind of sort of copied Kyle, but then again, Kyle kind of sort of copied other people who've done this before him. Kyle's a cool guy, I think he would admit that right away. But this was definitely inspired by his video where he was kind of revealing what he wanted to do with his commercial office space and some tabletops like these. I'm gonna tell you how I did all of this, show you some pictures, talk about issues I ran into, and give you some tips on how to do this yourself. Stay with me.
If you're sick of seeing that same Activate Windows watermark over and over, snag an OEM license from SCD Key. You'll have a fully activated OS in seconds, and you can kiss that watermark goodbye. And be sure to use my new offer code GSL for that sweet discount.
So first, what the heck is this? I actually bought this from my local Lowe's. I'm gonna kind of show you on my phone, although I'm sure the focus will not pan out very well here. So it's called Baltic Butcher Block, and this is a 4-foot section here. It's about 2 feet deep. I'll give you the exact dimensions somewhere on this side of the screen. But anyway, it is unsealed as far as I know. It needs to be sanded as well. So there is a bit of work that needs to be done to these to get them sort of like set up ready, if you will. But anyway, it's about 1.5 inches thick. It weighs several dozen pounds and feels super sturdy. Now, the concern with this, being that it weighs so much, is how I'm going to support it. Now, I could just buy cheap IKEA legs. That's cool and all, but I'd like to have no legs at all if possible. And seeing as though I actually own this house and I'm not renting a place anymore like I used to, now I feel much more comfortable bolting brackets directly into my studs. So that's what I'm gonna show you now. So these here are called shelf brackets. And I know what you're thinking, shelf brackets, why are you using these to support PCs and heavy birch wood planks? The answer to that is, well, these are actually rated for up to 500 pounds a piece. So if you use two of these, they stay up to a theoretical 1,000-pound limit if bolted into the studs properly, which I have done, I hope. And I'm here to say it is fairly sturdy, folks. You see, I've already got everything on there. I'm not gonna sit on them just because I don't trust myself that much, but I have put, you know, 100 pounds or more on these desks, and I haven't seen any flexing. I haven't heard any snaps, any creaking noises from the stud areas. They're just, they're sturdy. They really are. And I got white because my walls are white, so why not? So my woodworking skills are definitely not the best. It's actually the first time I've ever sealed wood, but I'm here to tell you that it is not difficult to do at all. You don't need to be a professional woodworker or carpenter to do this kind of stuff. The wood on the bottom, I did not sand as much, and I only sealed it one time just to make sure that, you know, I had proper sealing everywhere. You don't want the wood to warp over time if it absorbs moisture from one side, but I sealed the top multiple times and sanded in between those different sealing applications just to, you know, get that smooth effect that I was looking for. I think I used 200 grit sandpaper at first, and then I moved up to 320 grit, and that was good enough for me. You could probably get a bit smoother than this, but, you know, there's really no texture here, no chance of splinters, anything like that, if you seal it properly and sand at least to around 300 grit. Now, one of the inherent challenges of using multiple birch wood pieces to kind of make up your L-shaped desk or whatever look you're going for is gonna be leveling height-wise, getting these to match as closely as possible. You don't want a ridge on top. You don't want it to be really bumpy apart from just the gap in between that'll always be there. You wanna make sure that one piece of wood is not higher than the other. Now, the way that I did that, I'm actually gonna take the camera off of the tripod for a second here, show you what I used underneath. Definitely kind of janky, but you can see that just use these little brackets to connect both pieces of birch wood underneath. So it's pretty stealthy. You can't see it even from the side. You know, it's not very thick at all. I did the same over here, and I think it looks pretty good from the top. I mean, it's not perfect. You can see there's a slight deviation there, but I don't mind because my keyboard's on top of that. And I think this one actually turned out a bit better just because, yeah, I think it just got a bit more lucky there with the lining up the brackets on the walls. But anyway, yeah, that was probably the hardest part, and that's something that you will likely run into as well, just trying to get these lined up perfectly. Even using a laser, a laser leveler, it's just gonna be, you know, you gotta make sure that you're screwing in exactly where you want, make sure you're drilling exactly where you want beforehand, to get these lined up as close as possible.
Now, as for the cable management aspect, very straightforward. I used cable channels that I linked in the video description. You can see they look kind of like this. You can funnel cables into the backs of them and they're kind of held up in place by way of their shape. You can also use adhesive that comes on the cable channels themselves, or you could buy your own adhesive that's gonna be a bit stronger. I like to use the Gorilla double-sided adhesive. Really works wonders. I actually use it to keep the foam tiles on my ceiling as well. They are still holding up to this day.
But you can see how from eye level, the cables are almost completely hidden. This is an AC adapter that I actually mounted using that double-sided Gorilla tape. Again, that's in the description if you're interested. And of course, you can see where the cables plug into the power outlet there via the surge protector. Now, those are really the only two exceptions, and that was the goal. I wanted to keep cables as tucked away as possible from eye level so that when you're standing or sitting in your chair, there's absolutely no way that you're gonna see any cables hanging down to any length. So the Gorilla adhesive, that is a big one for sure. Using the cable channels, the little J junction channels, whatever they're called. And then also maybe if you're working with birch wood or something like this, using some nail brackets or whatever the older, more fashion term is, to keep the individual wires for microphones, things that are kind of standalone objects against the bottom of the desk as well. Keeps all those out of view or mostly out of view. And then from there on out, you're pretty much sitting golden. I mean, everything else is gonna be tucked away and you're gonna get compliments on how clean your setup looks, because most people, let's be honest, just have cables kind of hanging everywhere, and why it looks fine if you're not looking in that general direction, but if you're looking at a setup from far away, you can see just the clutter of cables hanging down if you don't have some sort of back covering there to separate the wall from the desk. I like to keep these things clean, not only for camera, but just for guests that come over. It shows that I care, you know, that's how I see it. And that's not to say that if your setup does look a little dirty, you don't care. Obviously, if you don't have the time to address something, that is not really your fault. You have other priorities that take precedent. But if you are interested in just revamping your setup, maybe you have a few extra $100 to spare, these Birchwood 4x2 panels are about $120 each. I know that's not cheap, but from a furniture perspective, I think that's a fair offer. And if you do a little bit of work sanding them down and sealing them, you're gonna have sweet solutions that are sturdy. They're gonna last you a long time if they're sealed correctly. The 19-inch shelf brackets are vital if you want kind of a floating desk, so to speak, to use Kyle's words. Cable manage. If you're gonna do this, you know, if you're gonna set up this kind of desk here, cable manage as best you can. Keep those cables out of sight. It to me is a night and day difference and will impress anybody either on camera or in person. By the way, if you're wondering why I just got 4x2s here and I have this little, you know, indention because I didn't get a full one, they actually had 8x2s as well. I would have, in an ideal situation, gotten a single 8x2 and then a 4x2 on this side for that proper L shape, but I couldn't fit an 8x2 in my car. So I didn't want to wait an extra couple of days to have it deliver. And then the delivery fee from Lowe's is like $60 or $70. And for one plank of wood, it just didn't really make much sense to me. So I worked with the 4x2 solution, and maybe in the future I could swap this out. It would be a pretty simple swap, assuming I'm willing to also seal and sand again, which is a bit of work, but take pride in that work. It will pay off and you'll feel good every single time you look at your setup. It's unique, it's your own shape, however you wanna do it. You could line your entire room with floating desks like these, and it's just, I don't know. I just really like it. That's why I wanted to do it. I saw what Kyle did in his video and I was like, dang, I've been wanting something like this for a long time. More desk real estate, much deeper desks. I can kind of control the height the way that I want. Most desks that are pretty cheap tend to be lower to the ground. These are a bit higher. I like that a bit more. You're in total control. That's the whole point of doing custom desks like these. Even if they're just floating, not on legs, you could kind of dice it up however you see fit for your space. If you guys like this video, thumbs up, subscribe. You can find all the stuff used to build what you see in this video down below. I'll catch you in the next one. My name is Greg. Thanks for chilling with me.